The purpose of the book is to help running and endurance athletes, as well as those that care for them, to either prevent or rehabilitate stress fractures or bone loss. We've appreciated, certainly in the last 5 or 10 years, a much higher prevalence of stress fractures and actually bone loss as a result of participating in endurance sports like running. I've been a physical therapist for 20 years and have had an interest in sports medicine, especially endurance athletes, for the majority of that time. I've been here at Penn State Sports Medicine for the last 8 years, and it's become increasingly obvious that there was a need for a book like this because of the fact that we are treating stress fractures at a much higher rate, as well as a much more recognized need for something for athletes and coaches to help appreciate how we can prevent and or reverse bone loss. Because one of the fascinating things about bone is that it's a tissue that is involved in mechanical loads, hormones, nutrition, and so there's a variety of factors that need to be addressed from a team approach. Mm-hmm. To go ahead and try to take care of an endurance athlete's skeleton, you really need to go ahead and have a team that's addressing all these factors that influence bone.
Any runner, especially a serious runner, or even a recreational runner who's going to be trying to do endurance distances, long distances, either marathon or ultramarathon, the biggest hurdle is actually getting to the race healthy. And oftentimes, it does take a team approach, looking at the biomechanics, the nutrition, the stresses, and the atmosphere that the person trains in order to keep them from breaking down or injuring themselves. And so it's very important to have a teamwork approach where you can work with physical therapists who are knowledgeable about running and endurance athletes, as well as physicians, sports nutritionists. All of them add a huge piece to making sure you get to the start line healthy.
There's been a tremendous increase in terms of our knowledge. 20 years ago, when we would treat a stress fracture, oftentimes we would look at the injury as a very, very localized type problem. But in certainly the last 5 or 10 years, it's become increasingly better recognized that oftentimes the environment that supports the athlete, especially nutrition, hydration, and a lot of other factors that are independent of the athlete's localized injury, have a tremendous effect. That's why, again, working with sports nutritionists and physicians, they can go ahead and test for biomechanical markers of bone remodeling, and we can go ahead and test for things such as vitamin D. And looking at nutritional histories become really, really the cornerstone of our multidisciplinary treatment. Dr. Robert Ecker is an expert in genetics of the musculoskeletal system. Bob has looked at adaptation of the skeleton over thousands of years' time. He's very, very well written and very, very well published, and he brings a tremendous amount to the book because his expertise in the musculoskeletal system, evolutionary, he brings that information now to the athlete's evolution over the course of a season, over the course of a lifetime. And so Bob really brings a terrific background in terms of the genetic component, as well as an athlete's ability to adapt to implied loads.